Hey guys, it's Brooke Herbez, and welcome back to my Favorite 16 Olympic Marseille Crimo, where I left off. He defeated Liverpool on the first leg. Here you go. From my Europa League last 60 match against them. And I also picked up a crucial win over Toulouse in the league. Why was it crucial? Because that win means that I need only 4 points from my next two games in today's episode to win league. Almost at the Serie A for some reason. My mind is all over the place. I am not in Italy. For this program, I am in France. A completely different country. So, yeah.
Welcome to you all. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. Alan's been assessing the conditions. It's raining. Is that going to help the attackers?
Winning this match would mathematically win me the league title, but only through my superior goal difference, and goal difference seems to not fucking matter unless you're on the same amount of points. So I have to at least, if I win this match, I'll have to at least get a point again. Insane it, yeah. And I'm well on my way to doing that as all right. Even very simple goal. Well, he was trying to get through on goal, but they're gotten away. He and Kadu gave the ball back to him for an easy tap in. Simple.
Delight for Marseille, now they're in front.
Now I know a lot of you might be watching this on Thursday, because of course Wednesday, when this goes up, is a transfer deadline day. Well, some of my fellow Liverpool fans are probably watching because they have nothing else to watch, because Liverpool are gonna do fuck all. I'll be watching deadline day, but I'm not expecting anything.
Ball either. Gonna try it. And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one.
Made a mistake there with the R and X and ran into the defender.
That will be a throw for Marseille.
That time he just defended well.
And that's broken up by the defender before the cross could come in. Kanjo.
Come on.
Into the attacking third.
Ooh.
They are level.
And clean prick.
There we go, at one all.
Fuck. Great play from the attacker. Dilly-dallying at the defense. I could almost see it coming as soon as he lost the ball. Well, that was pretty much it. It won one. It was almost a short. Get this shit out here.
Will be a throw.
Because it's clear my defense doesn't want to participate today. They're already on their league holidays. Hey, they're fucking... season isn't over yet, hey assholes. Just bash away.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Fine cross. Well, the ball deserved perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got there first, though.
Fucking ball for them. Foul? Of course not.
He certainly would have preferred that opportunity. Oh,
thank God. I was actually concerned that might be in the corner. Because that would be just like this game.
It's going to be a throw in after that tackle.
I'm 4 points away from the league title when it starts to completely fuck me over. Like, it's tried to fuck me over throughout the season and then failed at every turn.
But home teams usually do better than away teams. It could be a chance!
But it seems to have upped its game today. Lorient are playing like they're top of the fucking league.
We'll clear the danger.
Which is completely bullshit. Because I know for a fact they're not, because I am.
Powerful clearance. And throw with a bit of urgency about it. Keep the attack going.
Thiago. Yes, shoot! That's why he will. He opened the lead. He's reinstated the lead. He's now both my strikers have scored. And while I won't give Thiago an assist for that, I will. Because he, as much as the game doesn't want to credit him with setting up that goal. That goal was all him. If the keeper didn't parry that channel of shot, it wouldn't have fallen to Batshuayi and it wouldn't be 2-1. So, yeah. Assist from channel of goo, and now if we can get a third goal and just have a bit of a gap so in case the game decides to pull any more bullshit. Yeah, I'll still be in the lead. There's Tovan.
Here's the cross. And he backs it away. It's confidently done.
Dude.
Dig the ball into a teammate like that.
Come on, give me an option. Back over to Tovan. There's Channel Loop.
Kanjo.
And did well. Oh, well, I'll give him credit. And they will give me a corner. Thank you very much. See, it works both ways. And it's 3-1. And the goalkeeper came out like an idiot. Is it Simon Mignolet? He actually, I know for a fact it's not. The fact that he punched Rekic square in the face is.
Just a reminder, 3-1.
He says he scored.
Look at this.
So I guess it, either way it's 3-1, because that punch in the face surely, if the goal hadn't gone in, well, it should be a red card anyway. Just because I scored doesn't mean the keeper should still be on the pitch. But I know for a fact he is. It's not gonna matter. Oh wait, yes it is.
Just gone back to deal with that earlier incident. Yellow card. He's one of my favourite refs. He doesn't miss much this lad.
If he booked him for that foul, we'll just think. Everybody didn't book the keeper for punching Rekic in the face.
But top keeping.
And that don't do anything stupid.
The
I wanted a big kick up the fifth. Well, perhaps I shouldn't have passed it back to my keeper. Well, that happened because there's no one back to capitalize on anything. On this slight slip up.
That will be a free kick against Marseille.
Shuai dragged the Lawrence defender down as he was trying to win the ball. Chalabu! Ooh, good save from the Lorient keeper. In their corner, come on.
Well, the ball's been deflected out, so...
Yeah. And to throw for Lorient. Yeah, feel free to pass it around back there. You're twits. You're not gonna score from back there. But the R will feel for feels nice enough to give you a free kick, which they took short. Short and quick.
Obviously allowed them to take that quick.
Well, that works when it's an offensive free kick in the opposite, and not when it's a defensive free kick in your own half. You want to take that and punt it out on the field, especially when you're two goals down, perhaps three. Bash away! It's an own goal! It's an own goal, and you've almost guaranteed it. The league title. See? That is the danger when you put the ball in the box. The defender or went to control it. He miscontrolled it. It's an own goal over Zungu Torre. Another fucking Torre? How many are there?
A frustrating way to...
That must be a big-ass fucking family.
The opposition scoring with the own goal. And the,
or it's just a very common surname.
Four more minutes. Where there's life, there's hope. But there's not much life in the game.
Well, the manager on the sidelines waving his centre-halves forward.
The only thing is that they're not going to celebrate in the mathematically... The league has won after this. There it is, there's the full-time whistle.
Well, it turned out to be a different kind of game to the one perhaps we set up for you at the beginning.
No. Very one-sided. Over her jubilation, the fans are content. It's all meh. Why is it that just because it's goal different, I can't win the goal on goal difference unless we're on the same points? That's because that's bullshit. That is complete fucking bullshit. If you ask me.
Bordeaux 1. Let's have a look at what those results mean for tonight's league tables. At the top of the table remain Olympic Marseille with 87 points, with a game in hand on the team below. In second, Paris Saint-Germain with 63 points. In third, Saint-Étienne with 60 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In fourth, Stade Rennais with 58 points. In fifth, Olympique Lyonnais with 46 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In sixth, Nice with 46 points, but only behind on goal difference. In seventh, Monaco with 45 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In eighth, Bordeaux with 44 points. Bottom of the table, GFC Ajaccio with 15 points. Then leading up the table, second bottom, Stade de Rennes with 22 points. Third bottom, Montpellier with 25 points.
Sorry, I had to just switch off my mic for a few seconds because I thought I heard a weird noise. I don't know if you guys heard it. Hopefully not. If you did, I apologize. Again, this is purely so I can just, well, I hope to avoid injuries, but can never be too, never guarantee. Liverpool pick up the 2-1, and unlike at the weekend, they actually built on a Milner penalty, despite a defender scoring. See, this is how it should have ended against Spurs. Chris Milner scores a penalty. They equalize through a wide back's goal, which was probably Mignolet's fault. Let's not kid ourselves here. But Liverpool score a winner. See, it's not that bloody hard. It really isn't. But, no, of course not. And, of course, they have to make everything a fucking chore.
Ajax 1, Liverpool 2, Olympic de Marseille.
Match rescheduled. That is okay. Who is next? I don't mean that like Goldberg. I purely mean that as Villarreal. Interesting. An interesting last quarterfinal. Ties. I think we balance CSKA Moscow, Porto and Vitesse, and a bit of a London derby between West Ham and Spurs. Don't quite know what to say about that. Well, probably because I don't care about those other matches, because my job is to take Marseille to go free and not have to worry about who post is doing what. Seems very simple, but sometimes it's not as simple as you'd think it is. So let's get hang on. PSG played again! What the hell? Have I won the league yet? They can no longer catch me. They're 21 points. Behind, but they only have 7 games left. I have 9 games left. Seriously, what do you have to fucking do to win a league on goal difference? I have such high goal difference. Arise, yourself, well, calm down. All you need is a point. And that's not what I'm trying to. That's not my point. I realize that all I need is a point against Saint-Étienne and all with the league. But that was the case before PSG played. The fact that I have 2 games in hand after this is, look at that. They are on 24 goal difference. I am on 93. That is almost a difference of 70. It's actually a difference of 69. How is that not good enough to win the title? Do you honestly think I'm going to concede 69 goals in 9 games? That would have to be some sort of fucking record. Seriously, this game is retarded at sometimes. This is one thing I will not miss when FIFA 17 comes out. Some of the stupid decisions FIFA 16 is making. Chances are FIFA 17 will make the same stupid decisions, but you won't know until we play it.
Quite a few changes for Marseille. Steve Mandanda starts in goal.
Karim Rekic plays with Nicolas Nkolo in central defence.
They've got plenty of goal threat with two strikers in the attack.
Marseille are on the move now.
Oh, in goes the cross.
Sometimes attack is the best form of defence. They've been doing a lot of defense.
Come on, a nice early goal. Hope to establish my dominance. I just want to get this over and done with. The league is, you know, thoroughly pissed me off. Where I just want it over and done.
Past his man.
So when I'll challenge, but run straight into Saint-Étienne defender. You are a genius. Yes. No. On the pressure. It will pay off.
Yeah, the goalie was rooted to the spot there.
Nkolo.
Tovan.
Gonna cross it. Diarra.
Realistically, your draw could probably act. I mean, not a draw. I was going to say, realistically, a loss could probably even win me the league. Because they'd have to say, yeah, like I said, are going to have to beat me by a massive fucking scoreline to even have a big possibility that PSG could catch me.
If we don't, we won't.
So this should be, this could be a match to remember.
This could be a chance. Grateful for that.
The Saint-Étienne defender didn't make the same mistake the Laurent defender made. And the game is again emphasizing how stupid it is that I even have to play this game. And well, I'm just going to play this game regardless, but the Laurent game should have been where I won the league. Simple as that.
Away long.
Shawai forces a throw. Tovan.
Goalkeeper's got to collect the ball for a goal.
Screw you, Tovan. Screw you.
Marseille will be facing Bastia away from home.
Yeah, both sides have had plenty to offer this season, so this one should be a good tie.
It's almost an air of complacency amongst these fans here today. I hope it doesn't get to their players because they might fall on their faces, but they did win the away game.
Sometime today, you need to take the throw. Oh.
Really can't see.
See. That challenge. This challenge. And boom! Boom. The top goal score. Or after a few games of not scoring, and finally gets back on the goal score. And she. And has emphasized that we are winning the league today. I mean.
Now they're in front.
If it wasn't already obvious enough.
There on his birthday, no celebrations yet. By Assal,
here's a chance out in front of goal.
Excellent blocking there.
Oof, I'm gonna clear in the face.
Can he do it?
Oh, if he'd gotten there before Rufia, it would have been 2-0, and the game it would be in the palm of my hand going into the second half.
Well, it will be dealt with easily by
his poor cross means that Saint-Étienne might make it to after. Well, at least. Gap of only 1-0. Now press Porto. Pass? That's why the fuck not. Game, you cannot stop me. It is over. The league is over. Say it, and like I said, we'll have to score a massive amount of goals. To even try and prevent me from winning the league. It's over. GG. Done. Thank you very much.
1-0 here.
45 minutes, and the league is won. So far, the Hacking Channel Google was the only one of the match, but I aim to score another one. And just to wrap up the point, it's end the league title firmly. I'll be going for direct attacks in this second half because these passes are all going anywhere the game fucking feels like it. Like, the game. Anyone who wants to tell us just that this game doesn't have a buggy passing animation can only look at this episode and see. It not only does it have a bug here, imagine, it can make it fucking worse somehow.
We have league action for the away side. It's their next game, incidentally. By a sal. Gregory van der Veel. Benjamin Mendy.
Choi, Ben Yedder, 2-0, just past the hour mark, and it's game over, and it's league over.
Wanted in the bottom left. Just widened.
Game over, league over. Simple as that, ladies and gentlemen. As soon as I said the buggy, talked about the buggy animation, that cross, perfect. Exactly where I wanted it to be, exactly on point. Not past my fucking goalkeeper, because I'm actually surprised that this game hasn't try to pass to a guy in the box after running down the one and we cut back pass as Ed, like, says, you know what, you wanted to launch it to your goalkeeper, or that's clearly what you clearly want. I am genuinely surprised it has not done that yet.
Keeper's reached that shot.
While I should be more angry about that, about why he failed. We're about to win the league against 10 men, say at the end, because this guy should be fucking gone, please. Yellow? How is that a yellow? I was clean through. Yo, where's the option to argue that bullshit? That should be red.
Shots on here. Certainly going to be within their range now that the free kick has been given. Free kick taken. Well, the threat was there. Wasn't quite the goal.
I think the keeper might have been relieved.
Really can't make the best of a free kick.
Florian Thauvin. Past his man.
Here it is. Yeah.
Punched away by the goalkeeper.
Cut off! Thank you, dude. Pay attention! Ah! Oh, he was offside in a heated event. Maybe that's why he wasn't paying attention. He was busy complaining about a foul on him. Which is pretty much no news. Mates, as it's been the case all season, the referees don't seem to give a shit. Oh, yes! This idiot missed! Oh, it was a bad miss as well. Get back to training, you little bitch. I really thought that was... Well, that would have been, if not a consolation, goal. Oh, it doesn't matter anyway. Whether that ended up as a... Well, the fact that it was a miss leads to this easy bash away goal. Or, although, I don't know if this is going to go down as a... No, it's not going down as a Rufiero own goal. All my three attacking player. There's my two strikers and my... top goal scorer, Chanelogu, all getting in on the act. On the biggest... and... he of the season in terms of league football. Because... well, until we actually get the league trophy, because there it is! And this time everyone is celebrating. That's all. You can see he's happy that he's that he got to contribute on the.
Thoroughly deserve what they've achieved.
Oh, we're guaranteed a lot from this team.
Final goal that I needed. Well, I didn't need to score that goal before the league was assured, but I did anyway because reasons.
Stop it for a moment.
There it is. The full. And with that. Liga is done. The 29th of March 2016. A little later than it was wrapped up in real life, I think. I can imagine he's enjoying
at the top of the table remain Olympic Marseille with 90 points.
It because yeah. He wouldn't have won the fucking league with to lose.
Etienne with 63 points.
Especially considering they're fucking 13th.
With a game in hand on the team above.
Yeah. Olympic Lyonnais with 50. The league is won. You are welcome, Manuel. You are very welcome.
Monaco with 48 points. In 8th, Bordeaux with 47 points.
So, in the next episode... I was guessing we'll have a doubleheader of Villarreal, but if the first leg is a comfortable victory, then the second match will be this Monaco semi-final in the National Cup. Look at that. I have the semi-final of the French FA Cup, followed by the final of the French League Cup. Yeah. And hopefully by then I'll be in the semi-final of the Europa League. And to extra wrap up this episode, I'll throw in the simulation of this Bastia game, because why the hell not? 3-2-1. Hey! Even the second team is winning without me. He at the helm. Michael gets his first league goal for the team. Only two things happened in that. There was only two, like, highlights, as it were. In that game. The goal and the yellow card on the 44th minute for Bentaleb. Other than that, absolutely nothing else happened of note.
Liga 1, Bastia 0, Olympic Marseille.
Very interesting. Oh yeah, I signed you as a backup striker in case someone got injured, but no one got injured.
Second, Paris Saint-Germain with 66 points. In third, Saint-Étienne.
It's just the way, my friend. And that is just the way sometimes.
58 points, with a game in hand on the team above. In fifth, Olympic Lyonnais with 50 points. In sixth, Nice with 49 points. In seventh, Monaco with 48 points. In eighth, Bordeaux with 47 points. Bottom of the table, GFC Ajaccio with 15 points. And then
up the stats of players who are actually going to play in these last few games.
With 25 points, but only behind on goal difference. Fourth bottom, Troy with
25 points. So, next,
with a game in hand.
Depending on the result in the first leg of the game against Villarreal, well, you might see the second leg, you might not. If it's not the second leg, then it'll be the semi-final against Monaco. But, until then, thanks for watching. I'm Joe. Smash the like button if you did, subscribe if you're new to this. Well, again, if you heard noise like about midway through this video, I'm very sorry. I don't know what it was, and I don't, like I said, I don't even know if you guys heard it. If you did, I'm sorry. If you didn't, class. But, anyway, I just want to enjoy. Smash the like button for the winning of Liga. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.